Hi, I'm Bob McCauley. Welcome to Superwire TV, another episode of Around Leisure World. Today we have a very interesting guest, Dr. Ron Billings. Ron, welcome.
Thank you, Bob, for those nice words.
And Ron has written a book, The New Universe and the Origin of the Stars. And Ron, why don't you give us a little background as to your education to give us some perspective about where you're coming from?
Well, basically, I was educated in Europe. In England, I had a BS from Liverpool. At that time, I lived next to Penny Lane. I never saw the Beatles, actually.
Okay.
But they weren't.
So there was
around.
A Penny Lane?
There was a Penny Lane because I was living next door.
Okay. Now, was that a street?
Yes. Penny Lane, and
Penny Lane.
It's all in the song about the fire engine and the policeman's here and this, that, and the other. Well, I got a BS there, and then I thought I'd go on something like Peace Corps, and I went to Guatemala, but I was a little lonely there, so I went back and did a PhD in Glasgow, Scotland.
And what'd you major in there, Ron?
It was DNA or immunology, and how those subjects help with new cures for cancer and diseases. And after that, I was ready to come to the United States. There were better opportunities, and I was lucky to go to Caltech, which I think is the best school in the world. My professor has told me, well, he kept saying that all the Nobel Prize winners go through Caltech. I always remember those words of James Bonner. And then I went
to... It's a great promise.
I went to UCLA and did mainly research into cancer and tissue transplant rejection with Dr. Paul Tarazaki.
And what would you be doing there? Are you actually testing that with animals or with people or the transplant, the rejection? How would you actually do that testing?
We did it with people and taking lymphocyte cells from people and seeing why they were different, and trying to come up with something that would destroy the cells that were destroying the transplant. It's similar to cancer. I was very interested in molecules infusing, going inside the cell. And if we could stop that, we could control that process.
And your vocational jobs, what did you do after that?
After that, well, I was there and I did some teaching, and but to tell you the truth, I liked the research better. But after that, I tried to get some financing for myself because I could control what I
so
did.
You started your own company
did,
then?
I did start my own company.
Okay.
I started two companies, actually. One is called... Conejo Valley Cancer Center, where we looked for new antibodies against cancer cells. Mm-hmm. These are artificial ones, derived from a new technology called monoclonal antibody
production.
So how did you get into the concept of new universes or the origin of the stars? If your background was in cells and transplants and rejection and things like that?
Well, it was really a hobby. I think there are probably millions of amateur astronomers who actually make some great discoveries. And even if you go back to the man who said the Earth was round and not flat, he would start off as an amateur, and Galileo and... They're all amateurs. The professionals have come along since the big teams at NASA have arisen. But But I've always really been an amateur in that field and enjoyed understanding how the stars are arranged in the sky and so on. And when you're at a university, you have a chance to go to very many different lectures. And so I was able, if somebody was speaking about cosmology, I could go there too.
Now, I assume that basically you were talking about the flat Earth theory. You're saying that in your book, you're claiming in your book that basic science as it stands right now with respect to the origin of the universe is like the flat Earth theory, whereas what you've done here is reestablished a whole perspective on how these things come about and what the universe is. Can you give us a short, brief introduction there to what your theory is and what you wrote about in this book?
Yes, that's a good question, Bob. I believe it is as important as that concept. We couldn't really travel and navigate, explore the whole world if it was flat and you were frightened you're going to fall off it or something like that.
Okay.
So this is a new concept that people really don't believe in right now, but it's true. The stars we see in the sky, or the light, are pulses of electrons. They're a special kind of electron that are like lasers, and they're coming out of Jupiter and Mars and hitting our atmosphere to give the constellations and so on. And they're not coming from what we think of billions of light years away. I hope the audience understands what light year is. It's a distance light travels in a year.
Okay. So what you're saying, though, is that as current science thinks that we have our solar system and then stars out in the distance, and we're receiving light
no,
beams.
No, there's no light. I cannot see any evidence for light coming from a distance. I would say all the light we see and that the astronauts see came from within our solar system. One of the pieces of evidence are the photographs. They took many photographs going to the moon. But it amazed me, I saw immediately, there weren't many stars on any of those photographs. It was usually jet black. And I've heard Buzz Aldrin, some others, talk about the background being absolutely dark. So they couldn't see any stars.
So that was the basics of your theory then?
It was something that kind of accelerated what I believed in. So there are no stars, which in the Big Bang theory, those stars would be suns like ours. They're called thermonuclear reactions.
Like, so you're saying there was no Big Bang?
No, there was no Big Bang.
Okay, and you realize you're going to get a lot of arguments on that, right?
I hope not. I hope that people can read this book and see that it's based on science, and the scientists will realize, well, Ron's right. There are no stars out there.
So you're basically going to run it up the flagpole and see if anybody salutes them. And that's what you're saying is that instead of arguing with people or going to conferences, you're saying let's publish a book and then have people either attack it, critique it, show you why you're wrong, maybe modify it, or maybe get some ideas and things like that.
Yeah, they can compare the evidence from these books and decide themselves, even the man in the street. If for example, there's for example three pyramids together in Egypt, and some of those look exactly like constellation of Orion, the belt of Orion. And also that belt looks exactly like some of the volcanoes on Mars. And the picture's in here.
Okay.
I don't know if I could show a picture from here.